in spiritually, you are coming to different world. You are coming to meet different spirits. You are coming to stay with different family. The family you are coming to stay with. You don't know whether their spirit is bad spirit. You don't know whether their spirit is a good spirit. Okay? Hello? I don't see anything, okay? I'm just using my mind to analysis this. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel once again. If you are new here, my name is GINA. This channel, I create content about my life as a housemaid in South Africa. Okay, so if you are new here, thank you so much for clicking on my video. Hey, my returning subscribers, thank you guys for always being there for me. If you are new here, please don't forget to subscribe and click that notification button on, so that anytime I upload a new video, you'll be the first person to see the video. Without wasting much time, let's get straight into the video. So today, one thing I want to share with you today is that, okay, those back home, you know something, please don't come to Saudi, okay? Never try to come to Saudi. I know that maybe you may watch this video, okay, and you may think that everything is okay for me and I'm cool. Why am I saying that don't come? Here, we are not joking here, okay? We are no joking, like we are on the war, we work 24/7. So if you know that you are in Ghana and you are like a mama bada daba, you don't hustle, you are not a hustler, okay? And but you get food to eat, you get something small, you are not doing that much hard work, hard extra, but you get food to eat, at least stay there, be there and do it small, okay? Don't think that we are here and we take a lot of money, so you also want to come here. My dear, mind you that here we are on a war. We are on a spiritual war and a physical war, okay? Let me share this with you. Some days ago, I think almost a week ago, I don't know when I will upload this video, but some days ago, it happened in this February that a girl has gone mad. But I don't know, well, some are saying the videos is from Saudi, others too are saying from Oman. That lady is from Ghana and she has gone mad, okay? Me, if I'm here and I see someone has gone mad, like it's not a new thing to me, and I knew maybe it may happen. I will not be surprised, because we are working under depression. We are working under pressure. Like, we don't see different people. We don't refresh our mind, always taking pressure from people. Me, I'm working for 10 people. If you count them, 10, even if all of them meet, there are more than 10 people in this house that I'm working for. So imagine the pressure that will come on me if these people, all of them come and meet in this house. I do cooking, I do everything. Sometimes you may be washing, you may be doing different things, and someone will come and call you to stop what you are doing and come and do what they want for them. So imagine the pressure they will put on you. And you know, the only thing that can give you mental illness is stress. Stress will lead you to depression. Too much pressure and stress will lead you to depression. And from depression to that means you are going gray abadamba. Then now what dream, like kaboom. Because sometimes you may put something down there and you even forget where you place that thing, because too much pressure on you, and it can lead you to mental illness. And you, as soon as the depression catch you, the other day I talk about depression, how we get depression. Maybe that person may, those, you know, some people have stayed here for 3 years, 4 years, they don't even have access to their phone, they don't even hear from their parents, because according to, I think they don't even know the parent of the lady. So imagine, at least if you call your mom once a week, you may get some feelings, you may knew that you have the family back home, you can refresh your mind, you can get a different sound for your mind, okay, to refresh. But here is the case, maybe that person is not even getting the access to her phone, and you are working 24/7, no off. The only time you may get is when you are coming to sleep. So imagine how your life will be so terrible. Like, so if you want to come to Saudi here, yeah, please, if you are that Dabama Mapa, don't come. Because here we are not joking, okay? We work a lot. We work because some works they may giving it to you and it's not even necessary for you to be doing it. But because they think they have employed you and you are in the house, they will let you do it, okay? Before that month will end for them to give you that 1,000, they will make sure that not even a minute will go waste. You will not get your peace of mind. If you see a little girl shouting on you, my dear, like that depression, that pressure alone, you see someone that you can even give birth to, someone you can, you like, she's a little girl, maybe she'll be a little girl in your family talking to you like you were trash. Imagine the stress you get from that, the depression, because you may think that you are useless, you are nothing to them. Okay, before you come here, make sure you are strong spiritually, and also make sure you are strong physically. And I have explained the physical parts. You need to be hardworking. You don't have to be lazy. So let me talk about the spiritual world. Okay, the spiritual part. I come from a Christian background. I believe in God, and also I believe in the, like, the way they raise us. Okay, I believe in my forefathers, in our family. Every family have their own spirits that protect them. If you don't know, I'm telling you today, that's my belief. Okay, that every family have the spirits that protect them. Maybe your forefathers were worshiping gods at that time. They knew the words that they spoke with them, okay, that they build that family with. The family is on the foundation. There's a certain spirit, even if you were Christian, there's a certain spirit protecting the family. Even if it's the Holy Ghost spirit, that's what maybe they have built your family on, okay? So that's your belief, that this is what's protecting you. So let's see, you are leaving your family back home, you are leaving all your parents, everybody back home, coming here. You know, you are coming to different world. In spiritually, you are coming to different world. You are coming to meet different spirits. You are coming to stay with different family. That this family, they are also Muslims, and some of the Muslim too, they also have what they also believe. Okay, they also have something that they also built their family on. They also have their foundation, like the way I have explained it. We the travelers too, okay? So they also have what they have built their foundation on, okay? So now two spirits is coming to meet you, the spirits you came from your country, and you are coming to meet different spirits here. Okay, maybe you were a Christian, you are coming with your Holy Ghost spirit. They are Muslim, they also have their spirits there. So now you are coming to mingle with different spirits, different family. And that's where your spirit and that spirit, if it's God help you and they meet and they join together, that means you are lucky to go. I'm not here. I'm only using my mind to explain this. Nobody should take me wrong, okay? But that's what I have got to realize. It's a different spirits coming together. Okay, so you may never knew the spirits, the person you are working for, you are coming to work for, the family you are coming to stay with. You don't know whether their spirit is bad spirit, or you don't know whether their spirit is a good spirit, okay? So whenever you are leaving your country to come and stay with different people here in this country, you need to be physically strong and you need to be spiritually strong. You need to be very prayerful and you need to stay truthful to yourself with the people you are working for, because you don't know the family, you don't know the spirit in the house. Okay, so these two spirits is coming to crash, and you knew that if you have good things following you and you are coming to meet bad things, you know how it will go. Like, you will not take it easy. Okay, so that's why if we come, some God helps them and everything went good, and some people too may suffer. Because I don't know why you may see a whole human being doing a house help in Arab people's house and they don't like her, they don't want to see her face, they don't want to do anything with her. The only thing they will do is maltreatment, talk to her anyhow, do bad things to her. Okay, that means maybe the spirit that lady is having, it doesn't connect with the family the person is coming to work with. I don't know if I'm making sense, but that's what my mind tells me. Okay, I'm not a specialist, I don't see anything. Hello, I don't see anything. Okay, I'm just using my mind to analyze this. So you are coming from different spirits, different background, coming to mingle with different spirits, different background. So if you are not lucky enough, or God is not your side, or your families are not praying for you very hard, or you are not a prayerful, or you are not wise enough, you need to be vigilant. Okay, even the Bible said, "So you need to be vigilant. The people you are working, you are coming to work for, you don't know them. So you need to be smart. You need to be vigilant. Some words, if they tells you, you need to use your mind, because you have traveled. You are matured enough. That's why you have traveled. Okay. So before you want to come to this country, you need to be physically strong." And spiritually strong, because you are coming to meet different family, you are coming to meet different spirits, you are coming to mingle with different people, with different society, different culture. You know, these people, they are Muslims, but you know, everybody have something in their pillows. That's what I knew. Okay, so before you come here, you need to be very careful. You need to let your family back home pray for you very hard. And also, you have to know that we are not here to joke. We are working. We are working our ass out. Working 24/7. Even today is Saturday that I'm recording this video. I wake up around 12 p.m. in the afternoon. And now I'm recording this video. It's almost 4 o'clock. I haven't slept. I haven't slept. Okay. Now I'm recording the video, I haven't slept. So I'm only coming to sleep for 8 hours or 7 hours maximum. Then I'll wake up again. So you see how the body is. So if you couldn't put it in your mind, don't think we are only doing a house job keke. We are not doing house job keke, but we are on a war. Okay, so you need to be strong to fight it. Otherwise, when you get here and you see the work, now you will go crazy. And before we tell you, say, don't think we are doing a house job. You know how Ghana we do it. If you are house job, house help, you clean, you do, finish, you sit somewhere whenever they need you. Don't think we are coming to do those stuffs here. Don't think that I'll wake up early, I'll do my work, when I finish I'll sit down. No, it never happens here. Okay, even if you do the work fast, cry and finish, and maybe you are resting, they will come and tell you that you couldn't do the cleaning, or you couldn't do the work very well. Okay, they want you to always suffer. You know, we are slaving. There's nothing different between, or there's no difference between slavery here. Okay, we are on a modern slavery. We are fighting. So before you come here, me, I said don't come, but I know that one, you always give out the warning, but they will say they will come. So if you want to come here, prepare yourself very well. We are not joking here. We work our ass out. We work and we are on the war. So if you are strong enough, that means you are winning. But if you are not strong physically and you are not strong spiritually, that means things will be getting started. Even maybe Christ, not any spirit that is working against you, but immediately you see the too much work on you, then I start to say a foul to you. You may be thinking, when will I finish this work? How will I rest? I'm tired. Be doing complaint. You can't even do the complaint to anybody. You only do the complaint to yourself. You only say it in your mind. By the time you realize, now you will be talking on your mouth, whilst you are not talking to anybody. Okay? So I say don't come. Don't come. Be in Ghana. Don't come. But before you will come here, please, you need to be strong. You need to be hardworking. So this will be the end of the video, okay? The different things come all together. It's only few people who may understand this video. It's only the house helps who may relate to what I'm talking about. out. Okay, so you need to be vigilant, you need to be smart. Even if you're already here, be vigilant, be smart. And if you want to come to me, because if you say don't come, cry, you will come. Don't come, you will come. Don't come, you will come. Don't come, you will come. So this will be the end of the video, okay? If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and also click that notification button, okay? So that anytime I upload a new video, you'll be the first person to see the video. Always remember, no condition is permanent. Bye for now. I'm your girl, Gina. Bye.